For reasons that will become clear later, we want to consider a dynamic program for Knapsack that is different from the one you've seen before. This second dynamic program is very similar to the first, but it sort of swaps the role between the weights and the values. The subproblems for this dynamic program are as follows. For a value of I, we can only consider the first I of the items, just as before. And then we have a value of V, which is a target value, a total value that we want to achieve. And we are looking for the minimum weight subset of the first I items that achieves that target value. So we're kind of looking for the least heavy set of items from the first I items that have value at least V. And as before, we can simply relate these subproblems to one another, specifically if we already have all the solutions for the first I minus 1 items. We can build up the solutions for the first I items. For the ith item, there are only two options again. Either we do not select it or we select it. And if we don't select it, then we have to achieve all of our value v with only the first I minus 1 items. So we can just look up the correct solution there and copy that. If we do select item I, then this item already contributes a weight of wi, but also it contributes a value of vi. So the value we are left with that we still have to achieve with the first I minus 1 items is only v minus vi. And so we can look up the solution for that because we assumed that we have already computed all of those solutions before. And we get our result by using the best of these two options, selecting item I or not selecting item I. So we get, again, a simple recursion like this. We have to pay a bit of attention for some special cases. So if the value v is 0 or maybe even negative, then we don't need to pack any items. So the weight we need to achieve that is 0. And if we are not allowed to pack any items, but we are asked to achieve a value that is not zero or negative, but some really positive value, then there's no way to do this because we are not allowed to use any items and we are asked to achieve a positive value. That's not possible. And so for that case, we simply record infinity as the minimum weight that we need to use. Next, we have to ask ourselves, what is the running time of this dynamic program? And as before, we can simply picture this dynamic program as filling in the values in a big table. We start with the first column and then systematically fill in values for columns moving to the right. And filling in a single value in the table, say, let's assume it takes constant time, then the running time of this algorithm is simply the size of the table. How many cells are there in this table? The table has n plus 1 many columns, so order of n. And how many rows does this table have? Well, it's every possible value we could achieve. So what values could we achieve? Essentially the sum of all the values of all the items. That would be, if we had to pack all the items together, that is the value we could get. We couldn't get above that. So that's at most how many rows of the table we need. But we can also think about this in a slightly simpler way because we don't need to be as precise here. And we simply say that the maximum value we could achieve is n times the maximum value of any single item. This is because we have n items, so if all of them had maximum value, then what we would get to is n times the maximum value. If some of the items have value less than the maximum value, of course, the maximum we could achieve if we sum everything up would be even smaller, but certainly n times the maximum value we have for every single item would be an upper bound on the total value we can get. So in total, we have at most n times the maximum value of a single item. Let's call this vmax, many rows in the table. And we have in the order of n many columns in the table. So the total number of entries in the table is in the order of n squared times vmax. Is this a polynomial time algorithm? Well, again, it might look like a polynomial time algorithm, but it's really not. So n squared is polynomial in the size of the input because we have to have n objects in the input, and to encode those we would need n bits at least. But there's also this vmax. And again, this is a number that is encoded in the input, and it's encoded in binary. So vmax could be exponentially large in the size of the input. The algorithm would be polynomial time if vmax would not be large. So if the maximum value of an item is not too large, then this is a polynomial time algorithm. And it's exact, so it gives us the optimal solution. In that case, we are done. So the only question is, what happens if vmax is not small enough? So vmax could be large. The idea behind our fully polynomial time approximation scheme will be to ensure that vmax is not too large, at the cost of losing some precision and therefore only getting an approximate rather than an optimal solution.